Welcome back, Health Accumulators. Did you know that cholesterol is the building block for estrogen and that low levels promote decreased HDL, the good cholesterol, and increased LDL, what we call the less good cholesterol? And this can promote plaque formation in the arteries and eventually heart attacks and strokes. So if you haven't already subscribed, please take a moment, tap that subscribe button, and don't miss out on any more opportunities to accumulate health. So today we're discussing the relationship between estrogen and cholesterol. Interestingly, both estrogen and cholesterol, they tend to get a bad rap. I mean, all we hear is I find negatively around them. When a woman's period is off, it's estrogen. When they're in PMS, estrogen dominance. Belly fat accumulation, estrogen again. Breast pain, must be estrogen. Endometriosis, estrogen again. And on the same vein, cholesterol, we hear heart disease, stroke, diabetes, blood pressure, all cholesterol's fault. How do I know this? Because the first thing the standard American doctor gives a person who has these conditions is a statin medication to block cholesterol production. Unfortunately, this is so simplistic. Way too simplistic for the human being. And there's all these side effects and false hope with lab tests showing lower cholesterol levels, but no lifestyle adjustment happening, and a person actually ending up with a poorer health trajectory. So simply suppressing estrogen, suppressing cholesterol, it's not the answer. Enabling their optimal balance, especially in the case of estrogen, ensuring just its optimal metabolism through the liver, optimal metabolism through the gut bacteria, that is what matters. So when you support optimal estrogen metabolism through consumption of colorful foods like fruits and vegetables, broccoli sprouts, when you limit your exposure to artificial estrogens, those mimickers like plastics and parabens and your coffee cup you got from an espresso stand that's laced with plastic. The parabens and beauty products, not only do you get to enjoy the best estrogen has to offer your body, that youthful glow, but you also get to see your cholesterol levels balanced so much more efficiently because of all the beneficial estrogen that's around. This is why when we look to support, the phases of detoxification within the liver, say with NAC or milk thistle or B vitamins or broccoli sprouts or other high-end antioxidant fruits and vegetables, we see positive changes in estrogen metabolites and positive changes in cholesterol ratios. In the same manner, consuming Lunchables, Triscuits, white chocolate mochas, and heavily processed flours, corn syrups will back up the liver, mess up our bile acids, and will disrupt the balance of cholesterol and estrogen. So is it cholesterol's fault? Is it estrogen's fault? I don't think so. Perhaps it's the inputs that are at issue. And what is fantastic when it's the inputs that are the issue, it's not just inborn errors in our being, we can do things about it. That is what I'm here to preach. So ladies, if you've had your ovaries removed, or say you've entered menopause, it's a great time to check your estrogen status, to check the metabolism, the metabolites of your estrogen hormones, and to look at what your cholesterol ratios are. Where are your HDL? Where are your LDL? And if you're a guy, using estrogen blockers, recognize that though you do not want too much estrogen on board, you do need some estrogen, and you need an optimal level of estrogen. Otherwise, you may think it's low testosterone that's dragging you down, but in reality, it could very well be the suppression of estrogen that's causing all your symptoms. And let's not forget the statin medications. If you're on them, why? What is the end goal you're looking for? What is happening to your hormones in the process? Can you get the same results related to cholesterol ratios with lifestyle adjustments? I bet you can. Without estrogen, men and women are going to find themselves in a world of hurt, in trouble. And the same goes for cholesterol. Without sufficient cholesterol, without the right ratios, we're going to be in trouble. We're not going to like our eventual health state. For those of you who have been accumulating health for a while, you're aware now that estrogen is not the enemy. It's not the bad guy. Cholesterol, is a necessity for every cell membrane in the entire body. It's a necessity for the nervous system. It is a building block for all of our hormones. It is the balance of estrogen and cholesterol molecules that is vital to health. And without that, yes, we will live in dysfunction. But with it, dysfunction will be a long way from us. So please understand, the information you offer your body, it creates the day-to-day health story you live in. You have immense capacity to transform your current state and literally your health destination, your health trajectory, by those micro choices you make day in and day out. And those are what are affecting your estrogen. Those are what are affecting your cholesterol. It's not just that this is just your genes. This is just your hereditariness. This is just your family tree showing up in your life. No, the food inputs, the activity inputs, the stress inputs, the sleep inputs, those habits, those are what are causing your estrogens to be the way they are. Those are what are causing your cholesterol to be the way they are. And if we're going to change that, it comes down to our day-to-day inputs. All right, I'm Dr. Matt. Hope you can like this, subscribe to the channel, share with your friends and family, and I'll see you next week.